tangle free float rig, eh? That's a big claim. Not sure anything could ever be tangle free, but more importantly, it's got you to come and watch this video because I'm going to show you a great rig that is really hard to tangle and something that ensures you're fishing every time. It's a rig that I use a lot, and you'll see the reasons why I use it and why it's tangle free. So obviously, when you're putting your rig in the water, a lot of the people suffer from tangling your rig in. One of the most important things is always to lay your rig out to the side, and this rig will not tangle as it's sinking down, and that's the most important thing to do. If you do get a tangle, hopefully you should be able to fall it out of it as quickly as possible. So I've got some 020 AccuPower, and I've got a 414s F1 pellet float. I'm just going to put three rubbers on the line. So the first thing you need to do, always just trim your line. Make sure you've got a nice flat edge on your piece of line at the end. It makes threading your rubbers so much easier. Three rubbers there. When I'm redoing a rig, I try to keep, like, you know, 12 inches of line top and bottom from the float once I've trimmed the rig up, because I can tie the new line to the old line and just literally thread the line on. But this is a rig from scratch, so look, 414s F1 pellet. Just wet your stem so you can put your rubbers on nice and easy and not damage your line. First rubber wants to be about an inch below the body of the float, so you're not crushing the float. One at the middle, and then the last one is like 7/8 of the way down. So look, there's the float beautifully on the line. Then you just want a little loop in the end of the line. If you want to use a loop tire, or however you like to tie your loops, often I do mine with a loop tire. But I'm just going to tie that there for you. Pull your line nice and tight. I've got my scissors just to trim the knot nice and tight. So there we go. We've got the loop, got the line. Now I just need to put the shot on. And this is the bit that you guys are really interested about. So when I put my shot on, I've got a tape measure here so I can measure along what I'm doing, and a little nail at the end. Some people might have some sort of system for tying this up, you know, anything like that can help you, but this is how I like to do it. So keeping the line tight at the end, slide the float up the line to about 60 centimeters. I'm going to do this rig with number 9 stots. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put a stot on this line, and I'm going to do it in increments that get smaller every time. So we're going to speak in inches. So the first shot will be on the hook length loop, and then 6 inches away will be my next shot. 5 inches away will be the shot after that. 4 inches, 3 inches, 2 inches, 1 inches. And that is called a taper. So obviously the idea being that the closer the shot, the faster they sink. So they sink fast, but those other shot just keep everything pushed out away and give you a lovely fall of the bait at that lower point. And it just stops it ever wrapping back over on itself. Now, dead simple way of doing it. If I can see my black marker, all I do is I get my black marker and just mark on the line at 6 inches, mark on the line another 5 inches further up, 4 inches further up, 3 inches, 2 inch, and 1 inch. So I've got these little black marks on the line, okay? And I can just get my number 9 stots, shake them out, and then I can nip them on the black marks. I don't have to like look at the tape measure. I can keep the line nice and tight. I've got a little set of pliers that I can just nip it on, and the little black marks, you, as you can well imagine, they come off the line super quickly anyway, but they are just a perfect super quick way that I can see where to put the shot on. Good friend of mine, Nikki Crooks, actually told me that, so I can't claim the glory on that one, but I'm going to tell you that that's what I do. Thanks, Nikki. It's really easy to use. So there you go. I've done those number 9s. This is a 414, so this is going to be bang right. So even if I'm fishing with pellets or maggots, worms, sweet corn, meat, anything like that, I've effectively got this taper of number 9s all the way along. And what I do is I'll check it in my shotting tube. Nice little tip for you here. I've got a nice, big, long, deep shotting tube, so I don't need to do this, but you might have something a little bit shorter. Just get your hook length loop and loop it over the top of the tip. Then everything's a little bit more compact. It'll still all operate on the... and I can test it there. And I'm pretty much about there with that. And then what I can do is I can literally, if I, let's say I needed another couple of number nines or something like that, I could put them just above that last shot. But I like to use, when I'm using a 1.5 mil bristle like on this float, some number 12s. And all I do is just nip on a handful of number 12s with my pliers. Two or three, I think, will get this about right. So I'll nip these on. And once I've nipped those on, I'll test it again in the shotting tube. There we go. I'll test it again in this tube, and I'm saying that's going to be about perfect. Yep, spot on. Half the bristle showing, that's what you want. Half the bristle showing, and then I can just wrap it up on the winder. All right, so look, dead simple. It means as it goes in the water, this bit towards the float is sinking faster, but the shot just keep everything falling down away. You cannot tangle that as it falls down. It will always push itself away. And it means you're getting this beautiful smooth presentation of your hook bait. And obviously, you're getting a lot less tangles, and you're fishing every time, so you can put more fish in your net.